Hi, in this video I will explain you how you can achieve data entry within SAS Visual Analytics and making use of SAS Viya Jobs. Before we dive into the live demo, I will explain you what are SAS Viya Jobs, what are the differences between SAS Viya 3.4 and 3.5 in terms of Viya Jobs, where you should store the data in a data entry project, what are data-driven content objects and how they are used into SAS Visual Analytics. And finally, we will have a live demo. Viya Jobs are available in SAS Viya. They are providing similar functionalities to SAS 9 stored processes. They are executed through HTTP requests. You see here a sample URL where you have the domain, the name of the server, then the web application, SAS job execution, and the name of the program that is being executed. You can also pass parameters in the URL. SAS Viya Jobs are executed on the compute server. The compute server is launched by the SAS launcher server. You have also the opportunity to use GES begin and GES end autocall macros. Those macros are available and provide the functionalities needed to create web output or PDF output for your jobs. SAS Viya Jobs are composed by different components. One component being the job form. So the job form, it's an HTML form that you can use to pass parameters and enter value. So this is the interface for the end user. The job form will then call the job definition, the job definition being the SAS code that is written by yourself using SAS Studio or within the SAS job execution interface. You can also use job parameters. The parameters will be passed to the job definition, to your SAS code, using macro variables that are available in the global scope. And starting with SAS Viya 3.5, you will have the SAS job prompts, which is an XML layout that you can use to create cascading prompts, for example. What are the differences between Viya 3.4 and 3.5, just in terms of Viya jobs? As I've just mentioned it, we have the job task prompt. This is a framework that you can use to create prompts for your jobs. We have now also an integration with SAS Studio. SAS Studio being the preferred interface when it comes to coding and writing SAS code. As you can see, we have now a new menu option called Job. And in that menu option, we have the opportunity to define the job definition, the HTML form, and the task prompt. We have also a new pane specific for SAS Viya Jobs. You can there associate a form for the HTML form, an existing one, or one that you will write yourself. You can also use the job properties, and the job properties are also showing the URL to call the job prompt. And you have finally the job parameters, which are defining the type of information that is passed in the parameter, if it's text, character, and the name of the parameter itself. When you do data entry, you need to store your data somewhere. Some things that you should remember about the CAS server supports create, read, update, and delete of records. It queues all the requests, so you can execute in a parallel multiple requests. And CAS also requires a bit more administration compared to an RDBMS, in the sense that you are writing the data into memory where CAS is storing the data. But if you want the data to be persisted across CAS sessions, by sessions I mean when you restart the CAS server, you need to use proccas util or proccas to save the data on disk in such a way that they can be reloaded when the CAS server is restarted. CAS does not provide commit or rollback functionalities like RDBMS provides, and CAS has no lock mechanism, nor at the table, nor at the row level, as you would have using SAS share or using an RDBMS. So when do you use CAS or an RDBMS. I would say use an RDBMS whenever possible, as these systems are really designed for high frequency activities. So when to use the CAS server then? When you do a small scale data entry project, or when you don't have access to an RDBMS. What are data-driven content objects? So in our project here, we will use the data-driven content object to display an HTML page where we enter data for the load into CAS. So data-driven content objects are used within VA. They can pass data from the VA report to an external web application that is available on a web server. You can pass filter from the other objects available in VA to the web application that you have developed. So it's going in both ways. So you can filter based on a graph and filter the content of a data-driven content object, but you can also filter the graph based on the objects that are used in data-driven content. It's a nice and easy way to create specific or specialized visualization that might not be available out of the box. So if you want to integrate with D3GS or CanvasGS or Google Graph, that's possible. It's also an easy way to integrate dynamic content with other web applications. So for example, you can pass a value to the data-driven content object and return the stock exchange for a specific company, for example. So it's now time to dive into the live demo. Before going to the real code, I will explain you the flow of actions within the application. The SAS code I have created will not use the HTML form of the job execution functionality. Instead, it will create HTML within the SAS code. The benefit of that is that you can generate code, HTML code on the fly with each execution of the job. We have four macros used in our application. One init macro, which will run the first iteration of the execution. It will copy the visual caslib table called quiz programming to a cas user caslib. The new table in that caslib will be questions. Then in our iteration, we go to the record. The record will just save the information that we've enter in the HTML form and save those information within the questions table. We are using an HTML macro. The HTML macro will generate the HTML form that will be displayed in the data-driven content object. If we are at the last iteration, that means that we don't have any more questions. It will display an HTML result, which is a summary page. And if we are at the last iteration, we will enter the finish macro variable, and that finish macro variable will copy the questions table from the CAS user caslib to the visual caslib. I will now go to SAS Studio. So this is the end result. I'm going to SAS Studio to show you the code that was generated for and used in this demo. So as I said, we have here multiple macro codes. We have first the definition of the URL parameters. They will be stored as macro variable. We are making a connection to the CAS server and defining two CAS lives, one called visual and the other one called CAS user. In the macro init, we are copying the quiz programming table from the visual caslib to the CAS user caslib under the questions table. We promote the table in order to make it available for subsequent execution. And we also generate some macro variables to know how many questions we have in our quiz. The finish macro will be used at the end of the execution. So when we are executing the last submit, the last answers to the last question. We will do some kind of modifications to specify which is the user ID and the date time when it was submitted. This is to get better information in our output table. And then we create the table if it doesn't exist on the visual caslib, and the table will be quiz answers. We can run data step code, which will append the CAS user to load that was generated here into the quiz answers table. We will do the promote in order to persist between sessions. We can do some other manipulation and drop table and delete source when we are really at the end of the execution. We have a macro record. This is using ProCAS. It's using the table questions and writing one row for each answer. We now come to the HTML page. This HTML macro is generating all the HTML results if we are at the last question of the quiz, or it's generating the HTML page to display the form that is used to input the data into our CAS user table. So the job execution will be called using this underscore program and value, the value being the location that stores the code. It's displaying the number of the question and the maximum number of questions that we have so that we know how many questions remain in our application. And it also displays the information about the int. In this case, this is a small int version where we just see the number of answers that are possible. This is it about the HTML macro. As you see, we are using the webout destination. The webout destination is the HTML page that will be displayed and used to stream the output of the data step. The HTML result will display the summary for all the variables and all the questions. So we do some CSS over here just to color with light green or red, depending of the valid or invalid answer. You see the checkboxes and the summary will be displayed. At the end of the code, we are using the call to the init HTML and finish macro in order to generate our call. In this case, we have not defined a form, so we will use the no embedded form option. We have the parameters and the properties over here, and the properties is where you get the information about how to call your web or your Viya Jobs. And then we have also defined a new parameter, the new parameter called output type, and the default value is HTML. Underscore action is another parameter, but this one is generated by default. So specifying the output type enforces the generation of an HTML page and streaming the result of our data step to the browser. Going to VA, you will see that this is the latest version. This is an enriched version. So I will select the job that we have defined. You see that we have here the quiz and not the quiz DDC. The page is now generated. You see that we have the question ID and the maximum number of questions that we have in this quiz. And in the int, we have a simple int telling us that we have multiple answers and we can choose for those answers. If we want to integrate with the data-driven content object and integrate extra information as we have seen in the int before, what we should do is within the data-driven content object, we will be passing variables. Those variables are passed as a JSON object to the data-driven content object. How are we handling that within our SAS code? We have here the other SAS code. The SAS code is the same except for the HTML page. In the HTML page, what we have done, we have defined some JavaScript that is available on the GitHub website provided by SAS. This code allows an easy integration. It will do the heavy lifting for you that should occur behind the scene. So basically what you will have to do is call this function, define your own function, and the function that you define will generate, in this case, the ints. So this is a HTML code or JavaScript code that will generate for each observation in the JSON file that is passed from the report to the data-driven content object. You will iterate and generate a line for it. And this is the only modification that was done. So if we are using this DDC version of our code, we will just change over here, define that we want to use the quiz DDC object. The application has now generated the quiz for us. We see that we get information from this table in our report. We can go ahead. Let's say we will select all those options. We will display and say, okay, everybody was right. We can store the data in the backing store and in memory. Submit. Again, the int. So we see that the int is generated for each and every question, depending on the information on the table. And we have now the final summary where we see what are the good answers and the bad answers. This is it for our demo. You can also get more information about job execution in the user's guide. If you want to see exactly and all the steps to reproduce the data entry example that we have seen, you can go to the blog series about data entry in VA. If you want to get more information about D3JS and how you can integrate D3JS using VA data-driven content object, you have also a blog about it. And if you want to get more grasp on data append and update on a global cast live, this is also available on our blogs. For more information, please refer to the VA documentation or check out one of my other videos or blogs. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insight and Expertise series for additional tips. Bye.